Just want to brush my teeth, don't worry. Well, it's Jacob here from LGB TV. I'm with the gorgeous Nick from Eagle Bar.
Go that far.
So, tell me, Nick, why Mr. Eagle competition?
Basically, it's kind of an all-round competition now. We've decided just to go that one step further. So it's not just about sort of the fetish. It's not just about leather or rubber. It's about what would you do to add to the community. So our community as a whole is more about sort of the aspects of things that you would add to it. So
that's really good, and you're so right about the whole community thing in Manchester. And the Eagle's got a bit of a reputation for being the fetish bar. How do you feel about that?
Well, I'm really happy about that. We are the fetish bar in Manchester. We are the, I really enjoy what I do. And I am sort of Mr. Fetish. I enjoy that aspect of life. I love that. And I would hope to encourage more people to wear kit in Manchester.
So how would you encourage the newbies and the people who are a bit nervous about coming here and doing fetish? What would you say to encourage them out?
Well, we have two amazing bars. We have the Black Eagle, which is more sort of, should we say, kinky, industrial, and then we have the Front Bar, which is more dancey. So, but we also, as of sort of 2 or 3 weeks time, we will be selling our own kit down here. So if you feel the need to come in and you want to buy a waistcoat or a harness, you can buy that here. So it's just all about adding something more to the mix. So what we want to do is just make sure that people feel happy and comfortable in their own environment.
That sounds really good. So what are your plans for Mr. Eagle for this year? What can he expect to do for you?
Basically, he's our ambassador, so I expect him to, he's going to have to do quite a lot of work this year. So my biggest thing is the George House Trust, so I would expect him to be around a pride. I'd expect him to be an ambassador for the charity and for myself as well. So I'm currently an ambassador of George House Trust, and what I would like for him to do is to carry on that flag. He is a fantastic specimen of leather and rubber, and I just want him to make sure that as many people know that the George House Trust and the Eagle Bar are one happy family.
So how important do you think it is for gay venues in Canal Street to raise money and awareness for charities like George House Trust and LGF and Albert Kennedy and organisations like that?
To be honest with me, as we're currently in a period of austerity, and it's not an easy time for us. So for me, I am an ambassador for George House Trust. I love them to bits. We have to try really hard to encourage people in our environment to make sure that the lesser wealthy people are looked after. So for me, it's just that the George House Trust do a welfare fund. So people that are recently diagnosed with HIV, they have help with them. They are covered. They are catered for. I mean, I may own a bar in the village. It's great. But my only aspect in life is to encourage as many people to be generous and donate to charity. And that's all I want.
That sounds really good. So what's the next big event for the Eagle over the summer?
Wow, that's quite a good question. Wow, thank you, Jacob. That's really thrown it on me. And the next big event will be, we're completely refurbing downstairs. So we're not going to shut. We're going to keep the back bar open during the week, but we're going to completely refurb the front. So we're going more industrial. We are in the middle of buying the whole building, so we'll be able to do fetish parties upstairs, private events, weddings. We're also linked to the tea rooms, which is Richmond Tea Rooms. So we'll also be doing sort of catered events between the two. But also for us, we're going to be launching the brand new brand, which is called Mr. Eagle, over the next 3 or 4 weeks. So it's our own gay brand based in Manchester, and it's a brand new thing.
My God, that sounds like really interesting. So people will need to keep their eyes peeled for that. One last thing, because I know you're a busy guy. What would you say to encourage people to Manchester who've never been before?
Well, basically, we have the most diverse culture in the whole of Europe. we have 2, 3, 4, 5 streets which are based in Manchester around the whole gay area. So not only do we just have the pot, we have every aspect. We have the sleeves, we have the leather, the rubber, the bondage. We have every aspect of gay culture in the world. We provide the biggest, friendliest city there is to offer. So what I would like to say to people is that basically come to Manchester, experience the whole gay scene, but just don't limit it to just the gay scene. Experience the whole city.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Nick. Have a good night. And we'll look forward to seeing the ego expand. Thank you.
You're a bastard. Thank you. You're an absolute shitbag.